what are entities, why are they different to keywords and topics, and why is it important anyway for us as marketers? And that's what I want to talk about today, because it's actually much more important than a lot of SEOs realize, the difference between entities, topics, and keywords. Keywords really, for most SEOs, are just, you know, are words. They're words. They could be in any language. They could be many, many different synonyms for the same idea. A topic, however, is really a subset of that. A topic is not actually language specific usually. You know, the Eiffel Tower is the Eiffel Tower, whichever language you put it in. So it's a subset of keywords. It's made up and described by keywords. But the thing is, the amount of topics in the world is a lot less than the number of keywords in the world. And an entity is really a database definition or an article definition of all the topics in the world. So the number of entities in the world is a subset of the number of topics in the world, which is a subset of the number of keywords in the world. And the thing that, there's two real reasons why this is really, really valuable for search engines, for marketing in general. The first is that it takes a lot less data to store records on all the number of entities in the world. And so it's much easier for machines to structure that information and to be able to find similarities between information. But also at the same time, if you try to use topics, then there are papers all around the world now on topic modeling. Topic modeling marketing, Reisenbecker and Reuterer did an article that summarized over 60 articles around topic modeling in marketing back in 2019, so some time back now. And one of the things that they found was a problem is that the number of the topics in the world and the different algorithms and different papers and the different things that scientists and researchers were trying had a problem because they couldn't talk to each other because everyone was using different definitions of what topics were. And so they were reading content and not having a common dictionary, if you like, of topics. Now, this is important because entities and a knowledge graph can give you a definition of all the topics that you could then transpose onto different things, whether it's a PDF file over there or a list of library articles over here or web pages over there or product lines, whatever it may be. You can then use a common knowledge graph or database of concepts, an encyclopedia, electronic encyclopedia, if you will. And it's also interesting because of the way that Google seems to be thinking. Now, this is, if you want to get to this, this is free. I've put it up. It's the Google data link. I've got a link there at Google Ranking Signals on DixonJones.com. If we type in keyword here, it kind of sorts out the number of times that you use the word keyword. And it's got 27 out of 14,000 different entries in the Google link. They've used the phrase keyword 27 times, and it's similar for keywords in plural. Now let's have a look at topic, for example. If I put topic in here, then it's been used 219 times, sort of similar sorts of numbers for topics. Now let's put in entity. Down here, we've got 1,054 entries, and more if you put in the plural as well. So entities are being used within the Google link. The concept of an entity is being used much more heavily than the concept of a topic, and it's being used more heavily than the concept of keywords, according to just that quick search into Google's ranking systems. So how can we use this? Well, it may not be, that Google pays attention to this, but what you can do is think about your web content in terms of those entities in knowledge graphs. And the knowledge graph that we use, because it's common to the whole world, it's open source, we know that Google understands it, is Wikipedia or Wikidata, specifically Wikipedia articles. And so we can say, right, okay, let's read a piece of content and just turn it into a fingerprint of the underlying entities. So this page on structured data, a little secret, it's about the semantic web. And so we can say, right, it's about a thing, called structured data. And that's the keyword. That's just a label, really. The keyword is just a label or a description of the content. But it's about this thing called the semantic web. It's also about this Wikipedia page on data modeling. It's about this Wikipedia page on data. And hey, it's got an error here. It's not really about dirt. Okay, let's fix it. Don't just go with, you know, whatever machines spit out. You have to think about these things. So these are that's a fingerprint. Just three articles in a big database, admittedly a big database of Wikipedia, and it's pretty much defined what the content is about. It's got mentions as well, so it's saying it's about these kind of ideas, click-through rates and web pages and stuff like that. But essentially, we've taken a large piece of content and tied it down to some data points. And if you are starting to think about your content in terms of those data points, those entries in knowledge graphs, you're starting to define and give clarity to all your content. I hope that's helpful. If you want to see the Dirty Secret page, it was way back in 2019, and I just put the code up for the benefit of the video. Hope that's helpful.